now that the installation has been done, here's my honest review of the iCares Matte Screen Protector for the iPad Pro. First of all, the installation was actually quite easy. It seems like there are many steps, but I really like that they actually have the stickers, the numbers, and all the things that you had to follow the installation. I also really like the fact that they've provided the cleaning products and the piece of cloth that actually helps you to take off the dust and lint from your iPad screen. That being said, as you've guys seen, it wasn't as easy to actually open the packaging. I think that something may have just happened during the traveling of this material through Amazon to my place. But that is just like a minor comment. And on another thing as well is that I have been using, so far, the one that I've been using was the TechArmor Matte Screen Protector for the iPad. So at the moment, I've only used the iCares product and the TechArmor one. I haven't used Paperlike. And the reason for me not using Paperlike is really the price of Paperlike is just a bit more. It's more expensive. So definitely, if you're on a budget, if you are considering getting a matte screen for your iPad, I highly recommend it, especially for artists and drawing, because the first thing that you get it out from your screen is that really glossy finish on the iPad. So right here, I'm just like straight up pointing at my side lights here, which help me light the studio lights that you see in every video. And as you can see, the lights are a bit more diffuse. You don't get that extreme glossiness that you get from the straight up from the screen of the iPad. So I do highly recommend something that I've been using for quite a while since I actually started making illustrations on my iPad. One of the first things that I got was a screen matte protector, but I've heard that is actually a little bit thicker than the Paperlike version, and that is actually a really good thing in terms of also the how much that it gets hold by the tip of your pencil as kind of like the resistance when you're drawing on paper. Because at the end of the day, that's what we actually really want. We want the feeling that we're drawing on a piece of paper, and that's what this product actually delivers. So you're not gonna feel like a super harsh piece of paper, but you're definitely gonna feel like you're drawing on a surface that reminds you more of paper than the iPad as soon as you open the box, and it's extremely glossy, and also the screen gets like your fingerprints really easily. That's something that always bothered me as well. So in fact, I highly recommend if you're making a lot of illustrations on an iPad, or if you do use it even for reading, I do find that the matte capabilities of this product really helped with the strain on the eyes whenever you're reading content here, whenever you're on a white screen with black text or vice versa. So there are many factors here that I find that are in favor of using a matte screen protector. And I would also say, as a basic set of rules, number one, do this indoors. Don't try to do this outdoors and in the light of sun. You actually want to do this indoors and if possible with a good amount of light, but with your windows closed. You don't want to have like a lot of dust coming in. You should try to place this screen protector around a dry place at your home or office. And lastly, you should do it reserving at least an hour or so to apply the screen. You don't want to do this like on a rush, especially because if you get some of this the dust and the lint underneath the screen protector, you do have to spend the last stage, I would say, just kind of peeling off the screen and using the sticker to remove the lint that's either glued to the mat itself or onto the original surface of the iPad. So now let's just try to do a sound test with the screen applied. I'm going to leave this product in the description box down below for you guys to check it out. And please let me know in the comment section down below, what are your thoughts about this screen mats? Do you really like them in your workflow, or do you prefer to use the original screen that comes with the iPad, the glossy one? Let me know in the comment section down below what's your opinion about the screen mats and screen protectors. And I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you found this really helpful. And if you did, please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Ciao.